So a keystone is a stone, a wedge-shaped stone in the middle of an arch that holds the arch together. So you move that and the arch collapses. Robert Payne, who's an American ecologist, showed that the ochre starfish possessed a ochraceus, that if he removed that, then, well, it's a bit of a disaster. The community fell apart. So the mussels that the starfish used to suppress became superabundant, and they dominated everything and drove very many species extinct. Similarly, sea otters used to be very scarce. They were hunted. And then the sea urchins increased. They ate out the kelp, and the kelp forests disappeared. And then when we started protecting sea otters, the sea otters increased again, the sea urchins went down, and the kelp reappeared. So Bob Payne also suggested the term keystone species. So a keystone species is one that has a disproportionate effect, like the ochre starfish or like the sea otters. And it's important to stress that it's a disproportionate effect. So an oak tree or wildebeest has a big effect, but you'd expect it to be because it's such a dominant species. And it's important not to make that mistake. And this is the arch that holds together the two parts of Sydney Sussex College. And the Sydney family crest has a porcupine on it, which is why there's this crest here. But I do think it's a wonderful coincidence that this keystone has a keystone species on it, because numerous studies have shown that porcupines have big impacts because they're herbivores that kill trees, because they disturb the ground, or they create lots of burrows that lots of other species use. So keystone species are really important for determining the structure of the community, and we've got to work out which are the keystone species.